Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, in today's video, we are going to see what are the different currents flows through the bipolar junction transistor, an example based on this. So let's begin with the topic. BJT is basically a three-terminal device, and the terminals are emitter, base and collector. Depending upon the construction of BJT, there are two types of transistor, that is NPN and PNP. In case of NPN transistor, the current flows due to the movement of electron, and in case of PNP transistor, current flows due to the movement of holes. Now let's see how the BJT current gets formed in NPN and PNP transistor. First, we consider NPN transistor. In case of NPN transistor, P region is get sandwiched between two N region, and base terminal is considered as a common terminal. We know that transistor is a three terminal device, but when we want to use it in any circuit, we require four terminals, two for input and two for output. Therefore, out of the three terminal, one terminal is required to be considered as a common terminal in case of BJT. Now in this diagram, base is considered as common terminal. Therefore, the input is get applied between emitter and base, and output is obtained from collector and base. Now, in case of NPN transistor, N region having majority carrier as electrons, P region having majority carrier as a holes. So when the proper forward bias is applied between emitter and base, the holes start moving from emitter to the base region, and this constitute a current that is called as emitter current IE. We know that the flow of electron is nothing but the current. In case of NPN transistor, as the electron move from emitter to base, the direction of current is opposite to the flow of electron. That means the direction of emitter current is from base to emitter. Now at the base terminal, electron get combined with hole and forms a current that is IB. The remaining electrons get moved towards the collector region. In base region, not all the electrons get combined with hole because width of the base region is small. Therefore, very few electrons get combined with hole. The remaining electron move towards the collector and forms a current that is called as collector current. Therefore, the direction of collector current is from right hand side to left hand side. Now, the collector current is also called as injected current because it forms due to the injection of electrons from emitter to the collector. So, this is how the various currents get generated in case of NPN transistor. In case of NPN transistor, the currents are generated due to the movement of electron. Now, let's move towards the current in PNP transistor. In case of PNP transistor, the N region is get sandwiched between two P region. And in P region, holes are the majority carrier. So when we apply forward biasing between emitter and base terminal, the holes start moving towards the base region. In case of PNP transistor, the currents are due to the movement of holes and not due to the movement of electrons. Therefore, the direction of current is same as direction of movement of hole. So, when the holes start moving from P region to N region, that means from emitter to base, it constitutes a current that is called as emitter current. As the movement of hole is from left hand side to right hand side, therefore, the emitter current also moves from left hand side to right hand side. At the base terminal, the holes get combined with electrons. As width of base is small, therefore very few holes get combined with electrons, and that constitute a current that is called as base current. The remaining holes are now moved towards the collector region, or we can say it is get attracted by the negative terminal of battery and forms a current that is called as collector current. So we can say that in case of NPN or PNP, the emitter current is basically sum of base current and collector current. But practically, as width of base is small in case of both NPN and PNP, therefore the value of base current is approximately 2% of the emitter current, and value of collector current is 98% of the emitter current. Therefore, we can say the emitter current is approximately equal to collector current. So this is what about the various current formation in NPN and PNP transistor. And practically, we always consider emitter current is approximately equal to the collector current. Now let's take one example based on the same thing. The statement of problem is, in CB configuration, that means common base configuration, that the diagram that we considered just now is the common base configuration diagram. So in CB configuration, a BJT has emitter current IE of 10 milliamperes and collector current IC of 9.8 milliampere. Find the value of IB, that means base current. Now in this case, the emitter current and collector current value is given, and we need to find out the value of base current IB. So let's first write down a given data. Just now we saw that emitter current IE is equals to sum of base current to and collector current. Therefore, value of IE and IC is given. So let's substitute the value. So when we subtracted emitter current from collector current, we get the value of IB. So this is also proves that the value of IB is very small as compared to collector current. Therefore, when we consider NPN or PNP transistor practically, we always consider emitter current is approximately equals to collector current. So this is what about the various current that flows through the transistor, an example based on this. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ekeeda. Subscribe Ekeeda. Thank you.